Welcome back to another edition of the Grasshopper Adventure Series Bike Races. If you're not familiar with what a Grasshopper Adventure Series is, it's basically seven different mixed terrain bike races that takes place each year in Northern California. They begin in the winter and they end in the latter part of the spring. Each course is unique and different in its own way, and they are designed to have some pavement and some dirt, and they are especially designed to make sure that there is no perfect bicycle. So I'm going to be riding my hardtail mountain bike. I have slick tires. That's probably not what was recommended, but because there's more clearance around the chain stays and the seat stays, I think the slicks are going to work well, especially if the mud is very sticky. It has a lot of clay in it. It'll be nice to have slick tires so I don't pick up as much clay. So tomorrow morning, we need to get up early and head up to Ukiah, get our registration, and head out to the start line. A Monday warrior, mean stride. Today's Tom Sawyer, mean pride. Okay, just got my Dyna plug set here. And set up these tires tubeless. So they're holding there actually. Wasn't sure if they would.
Move over a little bit.
How's it going this morning?
So far, so good.
Yeah?
Yep.
What's the ride plan? What's your strategy for the ride today, Sally?
No plan, no strategy. Go with the flow.
Go with the flow?
Yes.
Okay, did you bring some tubeless tires with you today?
Tubeless tires with a lot of tubes,
and
just
bring
in case.
Dyna plugs?
No Dyna plug, just tubes. Okay. Four of them.
Four, wow.
Just in case.
All right. These events are a mass start event. That means everybody lines up at the same place at the same time and they all we all start together. Men and women and different age groups are all racing and competing together. I was positioned in the very beginning of the course, somewhere around 50 to 100 back from the front. The race itself is relatively short. I think it's 40 miles or so total, but it has about 5,800 feet of climbing. And everyone stages on Ore Springs Road. You're given a timing chip and you're sent off all at the same time off onto Ore Springs Road, which is basically a giant climb that goes on for at least, 3,000 feet. It's around 20 miles before you turn off of Ore Springs Road onto the dirt road, which is Low Gap. Low Gap Road this year was incredibly muddy and slippery. I chose the completely wrong tires for that part of the course, although I had the best tires before I turned onto Low Gap Road. Over the top of the very first climb, I descended down and found myself in a group of about 6 or 7 people. I managed to stay on the wheels of that group, and I got to Low Gap Road, where there was a rest station there where you could get some free aid. It's basically a neutral support. They had Osmo Nutrition there giving out water and hydration drinks. You had Cliff handing out the gels, and there were some other snacks that you could grab before you departed onto Low Gap Road. Once I turned on Low Gap Road, I immediately knew that my tires were going to really set me back. The conditions were very muddy, and I would say the consistency of the mud was a lot like peanut butter. I mean, that's what a lot of people were saying, and I feel like that was a good adjective to describe it. But basically you would sink in, and for me with slicks, I wasn't able to climb all of the climbs. I had to do a lot of hike-a-bike. And even on the downhills, which you would think, well, you can make up the time on the downhills, I couldn't really do that either, because the road and the corners were so slippery, I was afraid I would just slide out. I think my overall time for the race was 20 minutes slower than last year, and I attribute a lot of that to just the conditions. This event was a lot of fun. There were some professionals there who were competing for the overall, and I did find a clip on Miguel Crawford's YouTube channel of the winners talking a little bit about the event, what was going on for them up on the front. And here's part of that clip.
Top of the climb, we started this long, wet, gnarly, slippery downhill, and I was like, all right, just don't flat. That's the only goal. And I think, like, what, within, 60 seconds, literally 1K to go, all of a sudden, Sandy comes by. I'm like, crap, the mountain biker caught me. And I kind of sit on his wheel. I'm like, all right, I'm just going to wax him in the sprint. And then, Mr. Mountain Biker really comes by. Wasn't sure how, like, nasty it was gonna be because we've seen your stories and stuff, but it was definitely a bit soupy, but like pretty nervous heading into like some of these big puddles and stuff, but nothing was too deep out there, and kind of rode with my group, kind of get a feel for the dirt, and then just kind of got to the front and went, kind of ate everything I had before I hit the dirt, and then just went full sand, and I really didn't think there was much of a chance. I kind of asked the guys at the top of Low Gap how far it was, and they said 3 minutes, and I was like, oh well, I'm just gonna send
so you two it. Literally didn't see him come. You
saw, no, I saw either of them. I didn't think, like, I was like, oh, almost to the pavement, I can't see anyone. No, I'm just like shredding, and then I just like caught a
okay. So I will post a link to that video. You should go check it out. With that, I'm gonna bring up the overall results. This is the overall. This is everyone grouped together. There were roughly, let's go down to the bottom. There was 368 finishers. So 368 people actually finished the event. I don't know how many people DNF'd, but it appeared to be more than that many people at the start line. So the overall, this is everyone combined, goes to first place goes to Jeff Kabush for a time of 2 hours and 29 minutes. Second place, Peter Stetna. And in third place, Sandy Florin. Congratulations, gentlemen. Congratulations to Jeff Kabush for an amazing comeback from the downhill. So again, I'll put a link to that video. You guys can hear what they were talking about, what was going on. All right, so let's see, how did I do? I finished in 97th place, which is about the same place as I did last year, although I did do it, like I said, about 20 minutes slower. So I attribute that to the tires. I don't attribute that to my fitness, because I actually felt really good going into this race, and I think I feel like I should have done better, but I guess it was my tire choice is what I can blame it on. All right, now let's do the overall for the women. Let's see. So for women overall, we have first place, Katie Hall, with a time of 2 hours and 56 minutes. Second place is Lauren Cantwell. And the third place goes to Mariah Wilson. Congratulations, ladies. Okay. I guess that's going to conclude this video of this first Grasshopper Adventure Series. There are six more coming. They're all different and unique. They're all a lot of fun. And maybe, hopefully, some of you will be out there for some more of these grasshoppers. And I guess with that, have a great evening. We'll talk to you later.